Welcome to this tank encyclopedia video on the Socialist Federal Republic of Yugoslavia SO-122 support tank. Feel free to leave a like and a subscription, as well as checking out our website for the full written article this video is based on, and countless others. After the so-called Tito-Stalin split that took place in 1948, the new Yugoslav People's Army, or JNA, standing for Jugoslovenska Narodna Armija, found itself in a very serious situation in terms of acquiring modern military equipment. The JNA had been heavily dependent on Soviet military delivery and aid in armament and weapons, especially armored vehicles. In the 1950s, the situation with the acquisition of military technology significantly changed. This period is considered to be the happier times of the JNA because of a sudden inflow of new armored vehicles, mostly from the West. In the middle of 1951, a Yugoslav military delegation visited the USA in order to achieve military cooperation between the two countries. These negotiations were successful, and shortly thereafter, several US military instructors arrived to help in training for the future equipment that would subsequently arrive. On the 14th of November, 1951, an agreement for military aid was concluded. It was signed by the leader of Yugoslavia, Josip Broz Tito, and George Allen, the American ambassador in Belgrade. With this contract, Yugoslavia was included in MDAP, Mutual Defense Aid Program. Thanks to MDAP, the JNA received, between 1951 and 1958, nearly 2,200 armored vehicles, including some 599 M4A3E4 Sherman. During negotiations, the American Army wanted to get rid of older vehicles that were on stock first, but as they dragged on, it was decided that delivery would contain only this newer version. The E4 was a modernized and improved version of the M4A3 tank. It was essentially an M4A3 wet stowage with vertical stabilization, upgunned from 75mm to 76. The Yugoslav M4s would be mostly used in military parades and for crew training in the following years up to the second half of the 60s. Due to obsolescence and lack of spare parts, which limited their use, it was foreseen by the Dvar II military plan to replace them with the Soviet T-54-55. After replacement, the Shermans were to be modified for other purposes. Bridge carriers, engineering vehicles, stuff like that. Unlike the T-34-85, whose parts were manufactured domestically and thus could be running for a long time, M4 tanks were not used during the Civil War in Yugoslavia in the early 90s, but they did see action in many Yugoslav and foreign war movies like The Republic of Uvice and, perhaps more famously, Kelly's Heroes. The JNA was obsessed with the production of its first domestic tanks. The construction of a new tank required a well-developed industry and also demanded a high number of educated and qualified personnel. Due to a bad economic situation, mostly due to the damage done to the industry and infrastructure during the war, the production of a new tank was not realistic or possible in the near future. An attempt was made to find a compromise if the production of the new tanks was not possible, then a solution may be to attempt to improve existing tanks. Several such projects were created during the 1950s and 60s. The first project was the medium tank vehicle A, then followed by the proposed vehicle B, self-propelled gun armed with a 90mm. A series of different prototypes followed next, the M320, M628, M634, and the T-34D. All of these were based on the already existing tanks, T-34s, M4s, M47s, and even T-54-55s. Perhaps the strangest and most unusual was the modification named SO-122. Which was essentially an M4 armed with a large 122mm gun and equipped with a Soviet engine, a combination of East and West. At the meeting of the Chief Military Expert Council held on the 4th of February 1956, it was decided to rearm one Sherman with the 122mm A-19 gun, and to test whether this modification was feasible or cost-effective at all. The idea was that by installing a larger caliber gun in the M4 tank chassis, it would extend its operational service life. At the same time, this would increase its firepower and allow it to deal with more modern tanks and be used as a heavy fire support vehicle. The project design was assigned to the Military Technics Institute, and the head of the project was the Artillery Administration. Fortunately for them, there was an independent earlier project with the goal to modify a few M4s by installing a Russian V2-2R engine. This helped to a certain extent to accelerate the development time and reduce costs. In August 1950, in Belgrade, a machine bureau, which consisted of 60 engineers and technicians, was founded. Its primary function and purpose was to analyze the parts of the T-34-85 Soviet tank and if possible, to reproduce them. If this task was successful, the next goal was to rebuild and reproduce this tank. By the end of 1957, both the engine and gearbox were successfully produced in some numbers. Some 71 new V2 engines were built, with 50 more planned by the end of 1959. The stronger V2R, with 520 horsepower, was built in limited numbers as well. In 1956, Yugoslav engineers tested the installation of the V2 engine on one M4 tank. The results showed that the installation of a new engine was feasible, but there was a problem with overheating. Next year, several modifications were made to the engine, but the overheating problem was still present. The tests continued for the next few years, and although slow, interest in this project was still significant. Around 3 or 4 M4s were equipped with the V2, under the codename M634, and one with a V2R engine. When designing the SO-122, besides the modified engine compartment, only the turret had to be completely rebuilt from scratch. The rest of the original M4 was unchanged. The work on the large tank turret, equipped with 100mm or 122mm cannons, started in the early 60s. Several designs were built and tested, and great attention was paid to the design of the turret due to the new rear modified engine compartment. One of the most important requirements was that the new turret should be able to rotate a full 360 degrees. In 1964, the 100mm project was rejected because of the great price. Work on the 122 A19 project, codename SO-122, continued. The 122mm A19 gun was designed primarily for the purpose of destroying enemy artillery at long distances. It was heavily used during the war. Modified versions were also used as the main armament on several Soviet armored vehicles like the IS and the ISU-122. The maximum firing range was some 20 kilometers with a rate of fire of 5 or 6 rounds per minute. The Yugoslav partisan captured several A-19 guns from the Germans during the war. They were used in the fight against the Germans, but because of a lack of ammunition, parts, and adequate towing vehicles, their use was limited. After the war, in 1947, some 66 new 122mm guns were bought from the Soviet Union. These remained in use up until the Civil War in Yugoslavia. Prior to the installation in the SO-122, this gun received some modifications. This included a hydroelectric system, the breech lock from a T-54, and a muzzle brake. In order to avoid any greater damage to the gun during vehicle movement, a heavy travel lock for the main weapon was also added. Besides the main weapon, there is no information about the secondary armament. The hull-mounted machine gun would have probably remained. Based on the picture of this vehicle, the design of the turret suggests that a second machine gun was planned, but this is speculation at best. It was planned that all SO-122 would be equipped with the new domestic-built engine. Because the tests on the new V2R engine were successful, a decision was made to use them instead of this modification. The crew was probably the standard gunner, loader, driver, radio operator, and commander. The dimensions of this vehicle were similar to the original M4 tank. Due to the length of the 122mm, it was certainly much longer than the original, but the exact details are unknown. The American SCR-528 radio was replaced with a British SET-19WF, with an operational range of 10 to 15 kilometers. As the SO-122 project was conducted under a great deal of secrecy, only a small amount of information of its characteristics, and only about one photograph exist. When the complete prototype was ready, it was sent to Banja Luka and Nikinci for first field tests, and by February 1, 1965, they were completed. The results of these tests showed that the mobility characteristics of the M4 tank, even with an increase in weight up to 33.5 tons, were almost unchanged. The top speed was increased up to 50 kilometers per hour, but on the other hand, the acceleration was reduced. The fuel consumption was also reduced from some 400 to 450 liters to 207 to 211 liters for 100 kilometers. This obviously meant more operational range, up to 300 kilometers. The big issue was the length of the main gun. More than 3 meters long, this caused some problems when moving on uneven ground and operating in urban areas or thick forests. It was not recorded whether there were any structural problems when shooting the main gun, despite its greater weight and recoil. But there were some issues with the turret ventilation and problems with the fumes that appeared in the turret during firing. These tests were considered relatively successful, and that this modification was feasible and not overly complicated. A preliminary decision for the production of 100 SO-122, or 96 depending on the sources, was made before these tests were even done. Unlike the prototype, it was planned that the production vehicles should use the original engine from Ford, mostly in the hope to start the production as soon as possible. Despite the production order for about 100 new vehicles, none were actually ever built. Lack of armor penetration of the 122mm in comparison with other guns in use, poor depression, poor elevation, which limited the fire support at longer ranges, development of new and improved anti-tank rockets, etc. The death of Joseph Stalin, and the gradual reconciliation of Yugoslavia and the Soviet Union in the late 50s, led to future negotiations of purchasing of new military equipment, including modern tanks. New deliveries of more modern Soviet tanks basically made this project obsolete. As the number of modern tanks increased, there was really no point to continue working on the SO-122. After nearly 10 years of development and testing, in 1966, on the orders of the State Secretary for National Defense, the SO-122 project was canceled. The works on similar projects using the T-34-85 were forbidden. Due to the great secrecy of the project, the fate of the SO-122 prototype is unknown. This concludes Tank Encyclopedia's video on the Socialist Federal Republic of Yugoslavia, SO-122. We hoped you liked it. Don't forget to check our website and our Patreon. And until next time, keep us in your sights.